China has just realized that the men behind USA's anti-China policy are Chinese people, and now Xi Jinping's regime is petrified. Ever since the coronavirus pandemic was gifted to the world by China, the USA, led by President Donald Trump, has rained fury over the communist regime of Beijing. Trump has drawn a clear battle line between the two countries with the able support of Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, who has been at China's Achilles heel for far too long. But there is another dimension to this newfound aggressive strategy from America. The confrontational stance that the Trump administration has acquired lately against China is being worsened by Chinese advisors having an unfavorable opinion of Beijing. Reports have come into light which state that Trump administration has employed China-born individuals as advisors in its close circle to create a game plan to effectively combat China at its own game by using Beijing's shrewd political strategies against itself and exploiting its weaker points. Yu Ma-shun, known as Miles Yu in the US, is one of the China-born advisors whose name has been doing the rounds of the political circles of Washington and Beijing both for orchestrating the aggressive China policy. Yu is a professor of East Asia and military history at the US Naval Academy and advises the US State Department and specifically Mike Pompeo on decisions regarding China. Yu's appointment had raised a few eyebrows within the US as he is a first-generation immigrant and has close ties with Chinese dissidents. However, he quickly gained acceptance amongst his American peers and is now the pivotal cog in the machinery for Trump administration. US Assistant Secretary of State for the Bureau of East Asian and Pacific Affairs, David R. Stilwell, had even called Yu as a national treasure of the US. Another China-born US citizen, Meng Chang, is the foreign policy advisor for Pompeo, and both behind the curtains have devised the strategy to push China into the corner. Chang is a tech entrepreneur and dean of the College of Engineering at Purdue University. He has been on secondment at the State Department since last year and acts as Pompeo's science and technology advisor. Chang, on previous occasions, has severely criticized China on its handling of COVID-19. In an attempt to corner China on its atrocities on minority Uyghur population in Xinjiang, the White House in August last year appointed Elnigar Iltabir, a prominent Uyghur American academic, as the US National Security Council's director for China. These advisors know the inside-out workings of the CCP and therefore have proved to be of utmost significance to Trump. Elizabeth Economy, director of Asia Studies at the Council on Foreign Relations, a New York-based think tank, said the appointments underlined the US government's values. Elizabeth said, "They weren't picked because they have connections to a dissident community or because the issues are sensitive to Beijing. They were selected because they have expertise that the administration values in terms of strategy it wants to develop with regard to China." Global Times, the mouthpiece of CCP, has even published op-eds criticizing the two Chinese intellectuals. Usually, China celebrates people with Chinese ancestry who have achieved positions of power outside the country, especially in a country like the USA. But because Yu and Meng's decision-making has hurt the CCP's cause rather debilitatingly, the Global Times showed no empathy towards one of its kin. The newspaper dubbed Yu as a hostile fanatic who wants to see the downfall of the Chinese Communist Party. Of late, the US has gone after Chinese tech giant Huawei and got it banned from the UK, France, and numerous other European countries. Now he is after TikTok and has given it the ultimatum that if the Chinese espionage company doesn't sell its entire US business to Microsoft in the coming 40 days, then it will be banned from the States. The US has pulled troops from Germany and stationed them in the Indo-Pacific with the already present US warships in the region. Pompeo had warned China that if it takes any reckless steps in the region, then the repercussions will be devastating. Trump leaves no occasion to term coronavirus as the China virus, and the wordplay might even have been effectively brought into Trump's vocabulary by his two Chinese advisors. Pompeo had even met the survivors of the Tiananmen Square massacre on the 31st anniversary in June and sent a message to China that all of its sins will be unearthed one after another. The people of Chinese origin sitting in the US are engineering the doom of the Chinese Communist Party. Trump has played a masterstroke here, and China is left searching for answers.